Welcome back to After the Fact. A motorcade of pink and green in Cagayan de Oro City on Monday as three incumbent officials launched a campaign endorsing the presidential and vice presidential bids of Vice President Lenny Robredo and Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio. ROSAT 2022 is being spearheaded by Albay Representative Joey Salceda, Zamboanga City Mayor Maria Isabel Climaco Salazar, and Cagayan de Oro Representative Rufus Rodriguez. Salceda says the tandem will be good for the country, the economy, and for the region of Mindanao. We're now joined by Zamboanga City Mayor Maria Isabel Beng Climaco. Good evening, Mayor, and thank you for joining us tonight on the program.
Buenas noches, Christian. Paz de Dios y abrazo de Nuestra Señora la Virgen del Pilar y San Jose. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Okay, thank you for that very contextual greeting. Okay, so this effort to campaign for Lenny Robredo and Sara Duterte, tell us how this started.
Well, first of all, I would like to greet all our women. Happy Women's Month. It started because there is really a spirit of volunteerism that's formed by women and young people wanting to contribute to our country, particularly from Bicol. And Mindanao, it is very important, Christian, at this point that we have to continue the gains of the economy of the country. And being Women's Month, it is very timely. So I'd like to thank, as what Congresswoman Joey said this morning, we thank all of the volunteers for being inspiring us to contribute to our country in order to make a very important decision to love our country.
Okay, we understand yung context ng International Women's Month. Pero itong specific push for Lenny Robredo and Sara Duterte, paano po siya nagsimula? Who started this whole thing?
Well, actually, when the candidates filed their certificates of candidacy, I have received young people coming to the City Hall, particularly last February 14. They gave me flowers and they said, they belong to a movement called ROSA. And then I think some time ago, they also brought us ice cream, silly ice cream, green and pink. And this is really a movement of young people, Zamboangueños on the ground. So it started with the desire of young people looking at the capability, the capacity, and the courage of women who have contributed in this time of the pandemic. And when you talk of crisis managers, VP Lenny Robredo, Mayor Inday Sara Duterte has really weathered the crisis and contributed specifically to Zamboanga City. My criteria of a national candidate is sino bang tumulong sa Zamboanga City ng oras ng pandemya? Si VP Lenny nagbigay ng mga PPEs, i-consulta, kanyang mga care kits. Mayor Inday gave RT-PCR and she even silently supported that newborn test screening. So I think these are very solid pieces of evidence of how women can lead in the crisis and yet be able to contribute beyond the comfort zones.
Mm. Didn't former Senator Bongbong Marcos do that for your city?
I don't remember of any action done by the young people. All I can speak of is about the movement of ROSA.
Okay. Pero to, gaano kalaki itong movement na to na binabanggit nyo? This effort to push for Robredo and Sara Duterte?
Well, I think for Zamboanga City, it had a very good following because yesterday, as early as around 7 in the morning, I have seen tricycle drivers, young people coming to the city halls, also preparing for the arrival of Congressman Joey. But it's a movement that has been silently being multiplied. And I'm very thankful for being part of our launch in Cagayan with Cong Rufus Rodriguez. At doon nakita ko yung synergy ng ating mga kabataan coming from Iligan, Cagayan, and Zamboanga City, forging their aspirations for two women candidates for president and vice president.
Okay, so pag-usapan natin yung pagiging babae nila. No? So we've had women presidents, we've had women vice presidents, but do you think the Filipino electorate is ready for a woman president at the same time a woman vice president?
I think the Filipino electorate must be responsible enough to look at the gains of how women as multitasks, doing multitasking is able to respond to the crisis. They have been tried and tested, Christian. I would like to go back to the pandemic. I would like to go back to them being elected and serving the country. And it is really about time that women be given the opportunity to lead. It is always quite difficult for us in the realm of politics that we have to be judged at a higher bar compared to men. Always the fear of kaya ba ng babae? Are we ready for it? I think kaya ng Pilipinong tanggapin ang kakayahan ng ating mga kababaihan, but always, Christian, in the context of men contributing, women and men contributing to our country.
Okay. I hope you didn't misconstrue my question. It's not in any way meant to be misogynistic. Kasi nadidinig natin even on the ground, no? Meron pa rin mga tao na nag-iisip na hindi gusto nila lalaki, di ba? Laging ganun eh. Kahit na nakikita yung contributions, in fact, mas marami at mas malaki coming from women leaders. Pero aside from that, let's go to the concrete issues confronting your preferred candidates in this particular campaign. You're staring at the idea or the possibility of Bongbong Marcos winning, at least if you go by the survey numbers. And your candidate, Len Robredo, based on the last Pulse survey, was second but with only 15% compared to Bongbong Marcos' 60%. So how does your push, your group, your movement intend to bridge that gap and make your candidate win?
The Cambridge word for 2021 is perseverance. Perseverance is a word which means that undaunted capability to strive beyond all the odds and challenges. Nakikita natin, ang tanong ko sa sarili ko, bakit kailangan lumaban ang Pilipino sa panahong ito at bakit babae? I think the war, the campaign, the house-to-house campaign should reach the hearts of every Filipino. Sabi nga kahapon, kung mahal natin ang bansa, kailangan bumoto tayo at gawin natin ang anong ikararapat. Christian, allow me to contextualize this in women's struggle of suffrage, her story of Filipina struggle. My abuelita, my grandmother, Isabel Cortez Climaco, was a suffragist. She was one of the Filipina women who really championed from house to house to get women to be elected. But remember, in that first struggle, it was not successful until eventually they tried. So the story that we're sending here is that ang aking pong lola, ang ating pong mga lola, ay nagpursigi at nagsakripisyo upang magkaroon po tayo ng karapatang bumoto. At sa panahong ito, we are called as women to also make a stake for the love for country and also contribute to our her story.
Okay. Nakausap niya na po ba individually or separately si Vice President Len Robredo and Mayor Sara Duterte para sabihin sa kanila na kayo yung pinag-tandem namin in our campaign?
Well, I have already spoken to them previously individually in the visits, and because they seem to be very, very busy. But I think that they also are, they already sent their Mayor Inday, sent their thanks for the support that we have. But it is very important that this movement that we're doing is really rooted on the ground. And for all the Filipino women that are listening to us, our sisters, grandmothers, I would like to appeal to you na tulungan natin ang ating mga kababaihan. And it's not about just women, but it's about the Filipino family.
Okay, in the case of Vice President Len Robredo, maliwanag naman ang running mate niya po is Senator Francis Pangilinan. Why can't you also support her preferred vice presidential candidate?
Because Christian, from the very beginning, I've already committed to Mayor Inday Sara Duterte in whatever position she would run, because she has been tried, tested, and proven to help us in Mindanao. Remember, she came over to Zamboanga to sign the sister city with us, and she looks at Beng Climaco as her ate, and who would not want to support our dear sister Mayor Inday.
Okay. Now, doon naman tayo sa kabila. Bakit hindi niya naman masuportahan yung preferred presidential candidate ni Sara Duterte, who is former Senator Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr.
Christian, in the first term of Congresswoman Lenny Robredo in 2013, I was already a city mayor. Sa dinami-daming mga representative sa Congress, she chose Mayor Bengkley Mako to mentor her in Congress. Si Lenny po ang pumili kay Mayor Beng at sabi ko, napakalaking karangalan para sa aking taga Mindanao na pinili ng isang representative and the wife of Secretary Robredo who also mentored us in 2010.
So since Lenny can you elaborate on that? So she sought your mentorship during her first and only term as Congresswoman. Okay.
I do that in, even I think in this Congress, I was invited to also speak on the new members of Congress for mentoring. But hers was a very special mentoring program with the Development Academy of the Philippines. Hmm. So we taught them how our office was run, what needs to be done in Congress, and how we could really deliver and perform for our own constituencies. That's what mentoring meant for us then. And I think it was really a great and a very humbling honor for me to be able to mentor a lawyer and eventually somebody who became the Vice President of the Republic of the Philippines. Since she chose me then, she saw the potentials in me. And this time, she has really proven her worth. Ako naman ang pipili kay Lenny.
Okay. Pero yun nga, given your experience, pero ikumpara po natin siya doon sa preference naman ng kandidato niyo for Vice President. Ang preferred presidential candidate niya si Bongbong Marcos. Hindi ba kayang ma-overcome nito yung initial admiration or experience or support niyo with for Lenny Robredo?
Christian, it is something that is personal to me. In 1984, we have experienced triple tragedies in the families. My cousin died. My uncle, Mayor Cesar Cortez Climaco, was shot in the head and was assassinated because he fought for freedom of our country with Ninoy Aquino. We might have forgotten the sacrifices of heroes from Zamboanga and Mindanao. But amidst the noise that we're experiencing today, we have to correct her story and history by recognizing the sacrifices of my abuelita, of Mayor Cesar Climaco, whose blood was poured for freedom. And that, for me, is a very sacred action, a very sacred duty that I have for my city and my country.
Okay. May mga nagsasabi po na despairing of Lenny Robredo and Mayor Sara Duterte. Pwedeng mas makinabang daw dito si Sara Duterte instead of Vice President Lenny Robredo because Lenny Robredo might actually put more numbers in favor of Sara Duterte, pero in the end, Sara Duterte might not provide those additional numbers that Lenny Robredo would need to be able to defeat Bongbong Marcos. How do you see that from your perspective as one of those pushing hard for this pair?
If looking at the perspective of numbers, it seems quite a challenge. It would take a miracle for us to topple the numbers. And as what I would really want to put this into context that we really have to persevere. We really have to work hard to champion every household to translate it into actual votes for two credible women with untainted reputations, women lawyers who really simply at the time of the global pandemic came out of their way to help Zamboanga City.
But do you honestly think that they can work together, assuming that they both win? We've had experiences with the split vote, yung hindi magkakampe or magkaalyado yung nanalong presidente at vice president. We saw this, for example, in the case of President Duterte and Vice President Lenny Robredo, former President Benigno Aquino III, and Vice President Jeju Barbinay. And now, you're trying to pair Lenny Robredo with Sara Duterte. And Sara Duterte had been criticizing the vice president. So is it even a good idea for you to come up with this pairing?
Christian, the uniting factor is Secretary Jessie Robredo. unknown to many, it was Secretary Jesse Robredo who also guided Mayor Inday Duterte as mayor in her first term. And when VP Lenny went to Davao to campaign, Mayor Inday personally took her out for dinner. These are very simple things that women do. And I think what unites the both of them is that they have a shared experience of gratefulness for what Secretary Jesse Robredo has done for Mayor Inday Duterte and what they have done for our country. So in that way, I would like to disavow any fears or concerns that there would not be any unity in the proposed synergy that we want for our country. Two women leading us and two mothers making a difference to contribute for the love of our families.
Okay. Have you also taken time to analyze, scrutinize the respective campaign platforms of Vice President Lenny Robredo and Vice Presidential Candidate Sara Duterte? Kasi si Vice President Robredo has been attending forums and debates and articulating in detail her campaign platform, pero hindi pa natin siya nakikita o naririnig on the part of Mayor Sara Duterte. So ano yung, did you even have that opportunity to examine the other candidates' campaign platform?
Christian, what is most important at this time for our criteria and my criteria as mayor of Zamboanga City, I will ask this question to all the national candidates. Ano ba ang nagawa nyo in the time of the pandemic? Paano ba kayong nakatulong sa mga mamamayan natin? And for me, the platforms are very vital, are very important, but Mayor Inday Sara Duterte has done a lot of responses for COVID. In fact, her latest executive order allowing the Department of Education freedom to open classes is something that we also imitate and we also duplicate in the city. These are concrete actions, Christian, that these two women have done at the time of the crisis. It goes beyond words. It goes beyond letters. These are concrete actions of what they have done. If these two women who already has proven their worth for our country are given opportunities to take the seats of government in Malacañang and the vice presidency, ang tanong natin, what more could they contribute to help our country improve and respond to the new normal in this new era as we face a COVID pandemic?
Okay. Zamboanga City Mayor Beng Climaco, thank you for joining us tonight on the program, ma'am.
Muchas gracias. Let women lead. Vaya con Dios.
Okay. Now, before we go, here are some of the reactions to the PDP Laban faction's move to officially endorse Bongbong Marcos for president. Senator Coco Pimentel, who is the son of PDP Laban founder, the late Nene Pimentel, has condemned the endorsement, pointing out that the party was established precisely to oppose the Marcos dictatorship. On social media, some netizens also wondered if Duterte himself would throw his support behind someone he once described as a spoiled and weak leader who only relied on his father's name. Acting presidential spokesman Martin Andanara said he cannot say for sure if the chief executive would back the party's endorsement. So that's it for tonight. This has been your host, Christian Esguera. You can watch this episode again on I Want TFC or listen to our podcast on Spotify. Now, for recaps and other exclusive content, subscribe to the ANC YouTube channel and catch up with us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. See you again tomorrow after the fact.